And we're back now, 7:41, with the new Miss USA, Erin Brady, the 25-year-old from Connecticut. Captured the crown on Sunday night. She will represent the U.S. at November's Miss Universe pageant. Erin, good morning. Congratulations.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
I am fantastic.
Right after this segment, I'm calling my accountant and firing him. You are an accountant.
I am. I'm a financial accountant.
How did you get from being an accountant to competing in Miss USA?
You know, it's always been a passion of mine. I've always wanted to pursue it, and I had said to myself, well, you know what, I think it's time for a change. I think I'm going to go for it. And I had competed 2 years in a row as Miss Connecticut, and then it landed my spot at Miss USA, and here we are tonight.
But I can't even believe I'm going to say this, but at 25, you are older than a lot of the other contestants, and as you mentioned, you've competed before, but only for a couple of years. Mm-hmm. Some might have thought of that as a disadvantage.
Yes, and I disagree, because I think that maturity-wise, you're at a different state. I'm more comfortable with myself now than I was 2, 3, 4 years ago when most people do compete. So I think that is an advantage.
So maturity does help in a moment like
help.
That.
Yeah.
You're an impressive young lady. I was reading a little bit about you. You've been through some tough things in your life. You've
yes.
had to be independent from a very young age. There's some family history of alcoholism, and I know you'd like to address that a little bit during your reign,
yes.
as they call it. What do you want people to know?
I just want people to know that you don't have to get caught up with things like that. You can actually make a better change for yourself, and you can come out on top, and to not be a stereotype and not fall into the tradition that sometimes happens when you're in a family of that kind of reputation. You know, you can rise up and become Miss USA.
You all, as part of the competition, have to answer questions. I think
yes.
your question was on a recent Supreme Court ruling on DNA
it
testing.
Was.
It's a nerve-wracking moment.
It is.
Where were you standing? The question I have, though, is when Miss Utah,
yes.
Marissa Powell, was answering her question that's now gotten so much attention.
I was actually standing right behind her. I was probably the second girl to go after her. And you're nervous for her, because you know that in a matter of seconds, that can be you. You're going to have a similar question. You are in front of millions of people.
And even though you're competing, your heart goes out to her.
Yeah, because you've developed a relationship with them.
Let's take a look at that moment, and
sure.
we'll talk about it on the other side.
I think we can relate this back to education and how we are continuing to try to strive to figure out how to create jobs. Right now, that is the biggest problem, and I think especially the men are seen as the leaders of this, and so we need to try to figure out how to create education better so that we can solve this problem. Thank you
Utah. Thank you so much.
You probably wanted to give her a hug.
You do.
Well, why don't you give
them.
You that chance right now. Marissa Powell is here in the studio, and we're going to give her a second chance. Miss Utah, Marissa Powell,
Hello.
Nice to see you. How are you?
Oh, I'm great. How
it's
are
nice
you?
To, it's good to have you here. Have a seat, please.
Good morning.
What was going through your mind?
Oh, my gosh. So much. I can't even tell you. I was so excited, and I was so nervous, and I got up to this top five question. I was the first one, and I got up, and the question was a little bit confusing to me, and I just started speaking without really processing.
And you're 21 years old. It's only your third pageant at that stage at
yes.
that level, and it had to be one of those moments you just wish you could have dug a hole and crawled in it for a second.
I did.
Can I
did.
Give you a second chance at the question?
Please.
All right. Here was the question. A recent report shows that in 40% of American families with children, women are the primary earners, yet they continue to earn less than men. What does this say about society?
So this is not okay. It needs to be equal pay for equal work. And it's hard enough already to earn a living, and it shouldn't be harder just because you're a woman.
That was very well done.
Thank you.
Marissa, thank you very much. Yeah, that was perfect.
Thank
and
you.
And before I let you both go, you mentioned that your grandmother was such an inspiration to you as a young lady.
She was.
You also just told me she couldn't be there.
She couldn't be there to see me, but she said that she was screaming at the top of her lungs.
What's her name? Want to shout out to her? Teresa? Actually, let's do it better. Teresa, come on in. Grandma, you haven't had a chance to see Erin since she won the Miss USA title, so come on in and get to say hi. Be careful.
Yeah, I will.
Oh, my God.
Here. Oh, my God. That's nice.
Teresa.
I love you.
Erin told me a second ago she called you the other day and said, Grandma, it's Miss USA. And you were so excited. So we just wanted to bring you two together.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations, Erin. Marissa, thank you very much for coming. And Teresa, what a pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you too, Matt.
It's a pleasure.